All right, Ty, thank you. Well, recently the CDC announced that about 1 in 36 children in the U.S. are diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder. That is according to 2020 data. To put that in perspective, in 2000, the rate of autism was 1 in 150 children. Here to talk more about these alarming statistics is Dr. Michael Quinn, President and CEO of Autism Support Now. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Margie.
Yeah, this is a huge increase, 317%. What do you look to as why those numbers are so high now?
So, Margie, there's a number of factors behind the prevalence increase. Over the last 20 plus years, there's been a number of policy changes. For example, in 2017, the American Academy of Pediatrics introduced universal screening for autism for all children when they go to their pediatrician for wellness checks with their parents, guardians. So that's a key factor. Also, we're seeing at a state and federal level a policy of inclusion in schools, which means that these children are easily screened, easily detected, and better diagnosed.
Yeah, obviously early prevention is a key, and more so as more kids are on the autism spectrum. What is Autism Support Now doing right now?
So, Marja, we offer, we have 9 pediatric clinics. 8 of them are in Missouri, 1 is in Kansas, and we provide early intervention services for children with autism. And it's crucially important, Margie. We know from research, the sooner we can intervene, the sooner we can give children a better developmental trajectory in key areas such as language, speech, behavior, and cognition.
So how does that work with the Medicare? Are other insurance payers doing the same thing?
That's a great question. Yeah. So interestingly, Margie, over 50% of our children and families we serve are actually Medicaid covered. Mm-hmm. And Medicaid have been wonderful to work with. They're very responsive. They will, so essentially it requires 2 processes. One is to submit treatment plans for approval. Medicaid will review in a timely manner and approve, which means in turn we can get children into services quicker. And also for our clinicians, they have to approve their credentials. Again, this is done in a timely manner, and it allows us to get children into services quicker, which again sets them up developmentally for a better pathway. Mm-hmm. However, we do work with other providers, and it can be a little bit challenging. And I would like to see a situation, not just for ASN, for other organizations, mm-hmm. where others are adopting the same kind of timely response as Medicaid are.
Yeah, absolutely. Are parents surprised that a lot of this is paid for when they come to you?
Yes. So yeah. When parents come to us initially, Margie, they will speak to a colleague of mine in our billing department, mm-hmm. so to speak, and they will do a verification of benefits. And if their primary provider, it could be a commercial payer, doesn't cover treatment, mm-hmm. then by default, Medicaid will cover that.
Okay, Dr. Quinn, are we any bit closer to maybe seeing these numbers turn around the other way?
I think, Margie, autism has always been there.
Yeah.
It's been there since the existence of humanity. Mm-hmm. I think what's changed is we've become more sophisticated at screening, evaluating, and diagnosing. And we have a more coordinated approach at collecting data at a local, regional, and national level. Yeah. And that's really a really positive sign for everybody involved.
Yeah, if people want to get in touch with Autism Support Now, where should they go?
They can go onto our website, autismsupportnow.com, or they can visit us on our Facebook page.
All right, very good. Dr. Michael Quinn, thank you so much.
We appreciate
you coming in this morning. We'll also provide that information as well at fox2now.com.